Hey guys, it's Yuhan. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I want to share with you my journey applying to the HCDE graduate program as well as other HCI related programs. I'll start with my academic background, why I decided to apply to HCDE and other master programs, my application timeline, preparation list, and eventually some takeaways for someone who are like me, who do not have experience in design or a full-time work. For my academic background, I studied data science and cognitive science at UC Berkeley for my undergrads and applied and got into a master program right after that. And work-wise, I had 3 internship experience, starting with a data science intern, which has nothing to do with design, and then an HCI intern at a startup, and lastly, a user experience design internship at the summer after my undergrad's graduation. And besides that, I don't have any full-time experience. Speaking of why I decided to apply for HCI master programs, the first reason is that I want a more systematic learning of the HCI field. There was no major of HCI or design or research in my undergrads, and I also made the decision to pivot pretty late in my junior year. Secondly, I was kind of curious about the intersection of the industrial practices and the academic domain. And even I was like thinking about if I want to apply for a PhD in the future in this field. And thirdly, it's more practical reason that I'm an international student, and also it was during COVID when I graduated, so the job market was really bad, and I was just really concerned that if I can't prepare for a job that I want. Here's a timeline of my application process. I started thinking about applying to grad school in my junior year summer, and I started to source different school programs and connect it with potential recommenders that could write me a recommendation letters, as well as checking the requirements and just getting myself mentally prepared to the applications. And then starting in the fall of my senior year, I took a GRE and Duolingo language test in October and started writing my essay for different programs in November. That took a lot of iterations with feedbacks. And at the same time, I was contacting 3 recommenders, which are my professors and my internship mentor, to ask them to write me a recommendation letter. So kind of giving them 2 months prior to my deadlines. After preparing for all the material, I submitted my application mostly in January and eventually got my decision out in March. I applied for 6 programs, which are CMU's Master of HCI, Georgia Tech's Master of HCI in the direction of immersive computing, UC Berkeley's Master of Design, UMichigan's Master of Information Science, as well as 2 programs in the University of Washington, which are the Human-Centered Design and Engineering program that I am in, and the second one is called Human-Computer Interaction and Design, HCID. Here is a preparation list. Starting with personal statement. Yes, after 4 years, it's that writing process all over again. And this time, to help myself get started, I started with mapping out all the meaningful academic and professional experience that's related to the human-computer interaction fields that I had during undergrads. And I mapped them out and then connected them in a slightly different ways according to each program's requirements or the essay prompts. I'll dig into more details in the later takeaways. And for recommendation letters, I contacted 3 people. 2 are my professors who led the HCI research that I participated in during undergrads. One is an AR project and one is an autonomous vehicle driving project. And I also contacted my mentor for a summer intern I did at a machine learning startup. Depending on who I'm talking to, I started with a connection between my experience and the Aspire programs, and also letting them know when the deadline is and if they need any help from me to write the recommendation letter. Third, the portfolio. The HCDE program doesn't require a portfolio, but some programs do, and some require a website link, and some require a PDF version, so you're really gonna check out at the website. And looking back, my portfolio that time was very different from the one that I used for job recruiting. I think it's understandable that students are coming from different backgrounds, so it's okay to have fewer pieces as well as more diverse range of projects that demonstrate your experience. Lastly, the testing score. Some programs do require a GRE testing, and I just wanted to get over it really quick, so I prepared for a month and I just took it once. And for international students, the language requirements, different schools have different TOEFL requirements. If you went to school in the US, you can actually waive your language score for most programs, but CMU does require, like, they don't waive the language score, so you have to retake TOEFL or Duolingo English test. Some of my takeaways from application process as someone who do not have design backgrounds or full-time working experience. So first, when you're writing the personal statement, what really helped me was to pick a theme that connects my past passion or past experience with my future aspirations. And all of this should be in a positive tone. It's okay to have non-design related projects. Pick the part that's related to human-computer interaction or the human part of those projects. And for example, in an AR development project, instead of focusing on the development challenges, I focus on the process of observing children in the hospital and understanding the design goals and design limitations, and then transferring them into a development requirements. To connect the theme, I mentioned that I am interested in exploring the healthcare and the AR domain in grad programs, even with some particular professors or their researchers listed. So by positive, I mean, don't just show that you hate everything about your past job or major, although it could be true, but instead focus on an element that's missing or that's overlapping with your future aspirations. The second point is about start early and recommend your sourcing experience. So if I were to start it again, I would go to the office hours more often, become a TA, or even source for HCI related research projects earlier in my undergrad years. But if you don't have sufficient time, that's totally okay. Just try to reach out to professor, even if they don't personally know your name. You can always start with your introductions, your aspirations in the HCI field, and how your experience in their class is related or even inspire you to pursue the grad school. Trust me, professors have done this a lot, so it's not going to be the first time they've been asked to write a recommendation letter. So after getting to know you, they can still, even if they don't remember you very well, they can still write you a very strong letter. And remember that their relationship with you, how well they know your characteristics, are far more important than how famous they are or their titles. Lastly is to reach out to people who are in your ideal programs. It's like recruitment and networking, but I was surprised by how many people are actually willing to offer help. And you can choose someone in your connection, your alumni, or even just co-email people on LinkedIn. Ask them about their journeys and why they chose this program. And when you build a relationship, you can even ask them to give you personalized feedbacks on your application materials. Importantly, afterwards, if someone have helped you, show your gratitude and keep them updated with your decisions. And maintaining these relationships and giving back to the community can be really helpful even if you're no longer in the academic field. That is a summary of my application journey. I hope this is helpful, and best luck to those who are considering or applying to HCI Master programs right now. Please comment below if you have any thoughts, confusions, questions. Bye!